Dr. K. Rajesh, Associate Professor, Department of Nautical Science, Emmett University. Today I am going to talk a topic on Ship Operation Technology, Unit 4, which is Safe Working Practices. In this topic, I will go in detail on emergency procedures and practices and personal protective equipment. Our first topic is emergency drills and procedures. As you all know, ship is a fourth mode of transportation. It carries goods from one place to another via oceans. When ship is in ocean, if there is any mishap or accident, it cannot get help immediately. It has to help herself by utilizing the manned resources on board. That's why every man on board is trained to get suitable practices which he can use on board in case of emergency. So we cannot wait for emergency to come. We have to be prepared for it. That's why every month on board, lot of emergency drills will be carried out so that people are trained. Most important thing in drill is muster. So every month lot of emergency drills are carried out, and most important point is muster. The purpose of mustering and drills is that person get acquainted with the ship's equipment, he knows what to do, he know his duty, he know how to tackle the situation. So when there is real emergency, there is no confusion, chaos or panic. Some of the important drills which we will be carrying out on board is boat drill, fire drill, oil spill drill. Like this, there are about 35 to 36 drills are there which we carry out every month. In a muster drill or a emergency drill, most important point that all person muster in a safe place. To do that, we need some signals. These signals are called emergency signals. These signals are displayed in muster list. Muster lists are displayed in bridge, engine control room, cargo control room, crew mess and conspicuous places on board. When a person joins the ship, he should first work he should do is know what is an emergency signal. There are some important emergency signals on board are general emergency alarm. General emergency alarm is 7 or more short blasts followed by a prolonged blast. Next is emergency signal for fire. Normally it will be continuous ringing of bell in general alarm and in internal alarm system. Abandoned ship. There will be a separate signal for abandoned ship. On hearing abandoned ship signal, you have to muster in boat station. Abandoned ship signal will be 7 or more short blasts followed by a prolonged blast in general alarm system and in internal alarm system, followed by an announcement in a public announcement system by master, abandoned ship, abandoned ship, abandoned ship. Another emergency signal is man overboard. Man overboard signal will be sounded when a person falls into water. It is normally 3 prolonged blasts, which means Oscar. Another different emergency signal and muster station required is for pirate attack. when pirate attacks, you cannot go to normal muster station. You have to go to a safe house, which is called citadel. Normal pirate attack, there will be a code word which will be announced in the public address system. My last ship, the code word was Black Rose, Black Rose, Black Rose in public address system. When you are doing the drill, once the drill is finished, there will be three short blasts. It indicates completion of the drill. On finishing of the drill, people will put all the equipment in their respective places and can relax. Let's discuss one drills in detail. One of the most important drill on board is abandon ship drill. In this abandon ship drill is given when we cannot stay on ship. On receiving abandon ship drill, we will lower the lifeboat and life raft and go in it and move away from the ship. So it means that either ship is sinking or like some major fire and all board, we cannot stay on board. Then abandon ship will be carried out. In abandon ship signal is, as I already told you, seven or more short blasts followed by a prolonged blast. In general alarm system and internal alarm system, followed by an announcement in public address system by the master. Abandon ship, abandon ship, abandon ship. On hearing this signal, all crew must proceed to their boat station. Boat station is a place where their lifeboat will be located. So in abandon ship, each crew member should have their life jacket on. The responsible officer will do the damage control duty, should report regularly to the master. In bridge, master will update vessel position. In radio room, satellite terminal and other automatic distress transmitters. So everybody know what is the position of distress and they can send the help to rescue the people in need. So once distress message is sent and alert to all other vessels, we will think of abandoning the ship. Before that, we have to check that all crew members and passengers are present. If anybody is missing, we have to organize for a search and rescue operation. We should not leave anybody behind unless it is impossible for us to help him. We will activate EPIRB. EPIRB means emergency position indicating radio beacon. It sends a distress signal to coast station via satellite. Once the distress signal is received by the coast station, it will send help to the lifeboat. Next is, we have to maneuver the vessel in a proper position and stop engines so that we can lower the lifeboat and life raft safely. If we got time, we should prepare ship document, especially we will try to take all log books so that in enquiry we can give them evidences what occurred and what all to be done and what all actions taken by the master and what all best practices followed. After once you are abandoned ship, you have to keep on sending distress signal till you get a help from other ship. Once you are rescued, you should immediately inform company. Next important thing we need to know is master list. Master list is a list of the functions each member of the ship's crew is required to perform in case of emergency. It is defined in the Chapter 3, Part A of the SOLAS Convention. I hope all of you know what is SOLAS Convention. Tell cadets what is SOLAS Convention. Yes, SOLAS Convention means International Convention for Safety of Life at Sea. The master list must be written in the language of the country of ship's registration and also in English. In ship where majority of the crew speaks a third language, the master list should also be made available in that language. What are the content of master lists? Most important thing, first the master list will give emergency signal for various emergencies. Next, master list will give muster station for various emergencies. Third, master list will give you your boat station. That means which lifeboat you have to go in case of abandoned ship. Fourth, master list will give your duties in case of emergency. Each person has to do a specific duty in case of emergency so that we can tackle the emergencies in a very proper manner. On board, to fight an emergency in a proper manner, the ship's crew will be divided into various emergency teams. The duties of emergency, that emergency teams will be displayed in the master list. Normally, these are the following emergency team, usually comprise of four subgroups: the command center, the emergency team, the backup squad, the technical team. Each subgroup will do different tasks and coordinate with each other subgroups. In this way, they will tackle the emergencies in a very systematic manner and very efficiently. So let us go into details what each team will do normally do. The duties of each team will be documented on a document called contingency plan on board. In contingency plan, it will tell what you have to do in case of emergency. It will also provide all the checklist so that we tackle the emergency in an efficient manner. The most important team in emergency team is command center. The command center will be located on bridge. The master is the overall in charge of the command center. It will be normally consist of a duty officer, normally third officer, AAB to steer the ship, and messenger to keep lookout, and passengers, if any, on board in a cargo ship. Next is emergency team. Emergency team will have a front job of tackling the emergency. In general, the chief officer will lead the team for the emergency on deck, while the second engineer will take charge for engine room emergencies. The duties of each person will be laid out in the master list and they will perform in the emergency team. The main part of emergency team is to tackle the emergency at its location. For example, if there is fire, command team will, master will be on bridge, chief officer, let's take fire on deck, then chief officer will be in charge of emergency team. He will fight the fire at the location of the fire. The log of the events will be kept by the command team. Next important team is support team, also called as backup team. It is normally head by second officer. The main duty of the backup team in case of emergencies like fire, collision, flooding, etc., to prepare the lifeboat and life raft and also give first aid to the injured person. Once it has prepared the lifeboat, life raft, it will go to emergency team and assist as required. For example, in case of fire, emergency team will be fighting the fire in the location of the fire. Backup team or support team on preparing the lifeboat and life raft and giving first aid to the required person will do boundary cooling. Next important team is technical team. The technical team is also called engineers team. It will be headed by chief engineer along with other engineers who are not in other teams. Their main duty is to maintain propulsion and maneuvering capability of the ship and provide auxiliary services to the ship as far as possible in the circumstances. After discussing about the emergency team, you should have known that person needs to be skillful, trained, and company will support them as far as possible to do their duties. So one of the important thing on board, we have to know ship is not an hotel. It is a floating machinery with a purpose to carry cargo. It is like a factory. So on ship, all the possible things would have been done to carry cargo as much as possible, as cargo is the bread and butter of the company. So if the ship carries cargo safely from one place to another, then only it will get the freight. Freight means the money paid for carrying cargo from one place to another. So all person on board need to be skilled. They need to look after themselves. Also, they have to be dressed properly according to the occasion so that they can tackle all the occasions properly. So persons on board will not be wearing normal clothes as we see ashore. Person on board will be always wearing clothes as people wear in factory to protect themselves from various hazards. This type of clothing is called personal protective equipment, normally known as PPE. In next topic, we will discuss about purpose and types of PPE. Most important PPE is protective clothing. In protective clothing, it is made up of good cloth which will resist water and chemicals little bit, and it will protect the body from neck to the feet. It is also called dungri or boiler suit. A person get issued PPE, some PPE at the time of joining, and one such PPE is boiler suit. He will normally get 2 to 3 pairs of boiler suit at the time of joining the ship. Next important PPE is helmet. Each person on board has to wear helmet in hard hat areas. The purpose of the helmet is to protect the head from the falling object. No person should go to hard hat area without helmet. Each person should have his own helmet, and he should wear it at all the times. The helmet will be provided with chin strap. He should wear the chin strap tightly so that helmet does not fall down when he trips or falls, and protects his head. Next is safety shoes. The purpose of safety shoes is to protect the feet. How it protects the feet is, the shoe will have the forward portion made of metal, which will protect the toes and fingers from hitting any obstruction. In ship, the decks consist of lot of obstruction because there will be ice to take lashings and to secure things, and it is made up of chemical resistant material to protect the shoe feet from any oil spill or chemical spill. It is also made of anti-skid sole so that you don't slip or fall on deck. Also, it is made, there will be a design to protect ankle twisting. Next is safety hand gloves. The purpose of it is to protect the hand from any hazard. There are different types of gloves. Leather gloves are worn when you are working in wires or winches. Similarly, you will be wearing rubber gloves when you are dealing with chemicals. Similarly, you have to wear gloves which is resistant to electricity transfer for working in electronic equipments. Some more protective personal equipments are goggle. In ship, you have to wear goggle wherever there is a chance of particles flying in the ice. One such example is chipping. Chipping means removing the rust from the deck. That time the rust will be flying in the air. If you don't wear goggles, the particle can enter your eye and it can lead to accident. And so goggle you should wear whenever there is a chance of particle entering your eyes. Once the goggle is worn, the work is complete, you should wash the goggle with fresh water so that you can wear it again and again. Next important PPE is ear muff or plug. It is normally worn in high noise area. One of the high noise area on board is engine room. Engine room will produce a sound of normally 110 to 120 dB, which is not a comfortable noise for the ear. So to protect the eyes from such high noise, we wear ear muff or plug. It will dilute and filter the sound so that you get a only audible sound to your ear. In this way, it will protect your eye, protect your ear from the high noise. Next is safety harness. On board, you know it is made up of metal. If you fall on deck from at least 1 meter high, you will damage yourself. There can be fractures. To protect you from falling down from heights, we wear harness. Harness, you have to wear harness whenever you are working at a height of 1 meter or above, compulsorily. Harness, one point is secured to your body and other point is secured to a safety strong point, so that if you slip or fall, you don't fall on floor. It will stop you in the air itself. Another PPE is face mask. Whenever there is chances of any contamination of face due to the environment, you wear face mask. It will protect you from the dust particles in the atmosphere. Next PPE is chemical suit. Next PPE is chemical suit. Chemical suit is a better suit than boiler suit. In chemical tankers, boiler suit is not sufficient. To protect the body from dangerous chemicals, we wear chemical suit. It will protect the body from the dangerous chemicals coming in contact with the skin. Next is welding shield. As all of you know, when welding, we get sparks which will produce ultraviolet rays, which are very harmful to our eyes. To protect the eyes from harmful ultraviolet rays during welding, we use welding shield. The welding shield will absorb the ultraviolet rays and protect the eye from the ultraviolet rays during welding. So dear cadets, so today we will summarize what we have discussed. We have discussed ship is a place where skill is required to work on board. And one of the way to do is to follow safe working practices. Safe working practices, nothing, that is doing the job in a better manner possible. So, and also prepare for the job. Safe working practices cannot be born on a day. You have to practice daily and time to time to gain the skill to do the work safely. So one of the thing we have to be prepared on board is emergency. When emergency occurs and the ship is at ocean, you know, help cannot reach us immediately. We have to tackle the emergencies ourselves. To tackle the emergencies ourselves, we have to practice, we have to know our duty, we have to know how to use the equipment, we have to know what should be done, what should not be done. We have to know how the ship performs in various conditions, what can happen, what are the consequences of doing wrong. So this can be only achieved by doing emergency drills. So emergency drills, we around 9 to 10 emergency drills are done in a month. There are about 30 to 40 emergencies which can occur on board. As per ISM code, we have to identify all the emergencies that can occur on board. Cadets, what do you mean by ISM? Correct. ISM means International Safety Management Code, which is the child of SOLAS. What do you mean by SOLAS? Correct. SOLAS means safety of life at sea. So we will identify 30 to 40 drills, emergencies which can occur. We will plan and document, in which document you will find duties to fight emergencies. Correct. Ship's contingency plan. So every year we will make a plan to do all the drills in a systematic manner in a month, and we will do 9 to 10 drills in every month so that crews are aware what to do and how to do. They will familiarize themselves with the ship's equipment and their duties. Tell me where you will find your emergency duties on board. Correct. Master list. Where is master list displayed? Correct. Master list is displayed in bridge, engine control room, crew mess room, officer mess room, conspicuous place on board. To do the work properly and cover all the part of the ship, ship is divided into various emergency teams. What are they? Correct. Bridge team will muster where? On bridge. Next, emergency team will muster where? In the emergency station. Correct. Next is backup team or support team will muster where? Will muster in poop deck or a place close to the embarkation deck. Next is technical team or engineers team. Where they will muster? Correct. They will muster in the engine control room. Thank you.